Louder. It's nice to have you here this morning as we come to celebrate not only confirmation, but also Father's Day and to worship and praise the Lord. So it's a wonderful day out there. How many of you thank the Lord for the rain this morning and asked Him just to send more drops of it? So, but we have to praise Him for what we have at first. So I just want to start out with a little bit of a story about our confirmants that is so touching. I had made up little wooden nickels, I called them, with their names on them. And the congregation was supposed to take this little bag home with them. And that person that they had in that bag, that was the one they were to pray for. And so they've been being prayed for ever since we started confirmation by different people in the congregation. But then I asked the congregation if they would also put their prayers in a basket and have the confirmands pray for them. And so we did that. And we brought all the little prayer cards that were there to the confirmation class, and we sat and we prayed for those that were on there. But the wonderful thing is that one of the gentlemen that we prayed for suffers really bad from diabetes. And as they began praying, his diabetes leveled off. And he said, I have no idea why it leveled off. He said, it's never been that low, and it's never been that low for that long. And so it was just, he gave a testimony at church here for that. And then he said, then I remembered, I had the confirmation class praying for me. And they did. They did well with that. And one of the girls especially took his name home with her, kept it in her Bible, and prayed for him every time that she seen it. So we have learned a lot in this confirmation class, and we have learned the most that God uses us mightily no matter what our age is. It all depends upon our heart. So I am so gracious and so glad that I have had the chance to teach and to talk with each and every one of them. Some days it's really hard to keep them quiet, but we learn a lot in the meantime and enjoy each other. So they have been a blessing, and they're a blessing to this congregation. So please join me in the greeting this morning. It is found in your bulletins. God, your teachings are awesome. Help us to love and study your word. We are lost. Your teachings guide us and save us. When others seek to lead us astray, your word leads us into truth. Like the sweet taste of honey are your words on our lips. Sweeter than candy
are your teachings in our hearts.
Your sacred word saves us through faith in Christ Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Your teachings are awesome. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, as we come into this place this morning, we come because you have invited us here. And you are here with us. So we come here this day, O Lord, to celebrate you, the Lord God Almighty, to celebrate you, the Lord Jesus Christ, and to celebrate you, the Holy Spirit, who has put this all together here in this place. We come with hearts filled with thanksgiving and praise as we worship you here this morning. I would ask that you would please join in our song, Amazing Grace. It will be on, as you can already see, it's all over. Please stand. Yeah. Oh, yeah, the pews are molded.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, I've been set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains unending.
Join me in the call to worship found in your bulletin. You may be seated, actually. We'll keep you down for a while. Okay. By the way, the pews are not bolted down, so, okay. Let us join in call to worship. If we have died with Christ, if we endure with Christ,
we also reign with Christ.
If we deny Christ,
Christ will also deny us.
If we are faithless,
Christ always remains faithful.
Alleluia. So let us sing and praise prayer and hear God's word this day. I would ask you if you would please take a moment of silence to invite the Holy Spirit into our hearts and our minds and into this place. Holy Spirit, please have your way here this day in all of our hearts, our minds, and souls. In the blessed name of Jesus Christ. Please join me in the prayer of confession. Living God, it is easy to become discouraged. Our confidence is quickly shaken. Our faith is fragile as we read in the storm when we falter. Remind us that we are your beloved, sisters and brothers with Christ. Teach us anew that you have chosen us as the first fruits of salvation. Through the sanctification in the Spirit, comfort and strengthen us. Give us strength to stand firm and hold fast, that we may follow you every day through the journey of life. Hear these words of assurance. We stand alone on the Father and on the Son and on the Holy Spirit, for there is no other God. We proclaim the name of Jesus Christ. He's alive. We are filled with the Holy Spirit. Unto the Trinity, we make our allegiance, and with grateful and thankful hearts, we bow before them. Please turn to your hymnals, page 70, and it'll also be up here, the Gloria Patri. Today we celebrate also fathers, all the fathers that are in this room, all the fathers that are not in this room that have raised us and brought us up and taught us many things, taught us how to use a hammer, taught us how to use a wood splitter, some things we didn't even want to know they taught us, okay? But we thank the Lord that they have, that God has given us fathers. I have a couple little readings here. That's, no one has ever said being a dad was easy. It takes guts to persevere through the questions and the decisions and the sacrifices of fatherhood. And yet, it is so much worth the effort. Our commitment to our kids often takes us to amazing and sometimes humorous places. You ever laughed at your kids? You ever laughed with your kids? Have your kids ever laughed at you? Laughter is good. So sometimes we cry with our kids. Sometimes we laugh with them. Sometimes we grit our teeth in frustration. But no matter how much time and energy we sacrifice on behalf of our kids, we will always get it back when we hear, I love you, Daddy. Recently, my wife told me that as she passed by her daughter's room, she heard her singing about Dad. Warm fuzzies began to tickle in my tummy, and as I thought about my girl singing about her daddy, I really swelled with pride. When she told me that this song was comprised of a sing-song repetition of I love my daddy, I love my daddy, was the first part. The bridge of this little tune, however, was, but I don't know why. No, I don't know why. Then the rephrase was this, I love my daddy. hey, I'll take all of this love of this little girl has to give me, even if she doesn't know why. And our last one is, it's to the fathers here. What do you like most about being a father? And only you can answer that question. What do you like most about each one of your kids? Take a minute, count the blessings, and write them down. The ways of being a father has enriched your life. And when you're done, pray a prayer of gratitude. Then find a special way to communicate to your kids that I too am glad. I am glad to be your dad. From the hearts of the fathers, all of them say that I am glad to be your dad. Let us pray for our fathers here this morning. Heavenly Father, we lift up the fathers of this earth to you and this congregation and those that are here this day. We ask your blessing to continue to be upon them. We ask, Lord, that you will grant them wisdom and courage and strength for days that lie ahead, but also joyful and glad hearts, for each one of their children holds a special place there. It is amazing, O Lord, your children and the children here will always look up to their fathers for answers. And sometimes the dads don't have them, but they have their presence with them. And for that, Lord, is an abundant blessing. We thank you for the dads here this day and the dads in our homes, Lord, that are not here. We ask that you bless them and you just lead them into your presence as we pray for them. In the blessed name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, amen. We do want to thank you, all you dads, for being here this morning. As we begin today, we will go straight to our sermon. And the sermon might sound like an odd one to be a confirmation one, but it's one of the best ones that are there. It's Paul's letter to Timothy. Timothy was a young man that Paul won to the Lord Jesus Christ. He was turned out to be one of his disciples. And as he was going, Paul and Timothy were being separated. And Paul did not want to lose contact with Timothy at all. He wanted to continue teaching him. So Paul wrote letters to him. We find it in the 2 Timothy in the New Testament, right, guys? The 2 Timothy in the New Testament? Yep, we got it. So this is how Paul addresses. Paul addresses Timothy as if Paul is the father and Timothy is the child. You then, my child, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. So you look at this in the confirmation class that Paul is actually telling you this, that these words are for you. They're awful for us, but they're for you also. And what you heard from me and through many witnesses, commit to faithful people who will be able to teach you and others as well. Stay close to people that love the Lord. Always look for those people that have the same kind of heart in you. Because if you commit yourselves to faithful people, you will have a life filled with grace and mercy and compassion. You will have a life filled that God will bless over and over again. When we call upon the name of the Lord God, He listens for our voices, always. And I can't imagine how many times He smiles when we say, "Good morning, Father." Praise the Lord. But stay with faithful people. Because if you decide that you want to do a different life, it's a hard way. With the Lord, there is promises that He has made to us all the way through. You therefore must endure hardships like a good soldier of Christ. Stay with Christ Stay with the Lord. Don't always think your life is going to peachy and creams, that it's going to be, nothing's going to be wrong. No, this is life. This is life that we face every day. But no, when the things go wrong, where do you run to? James, you run to God all the time. They also had a little wooden nickel to put in their pocket. That little wooden nickel that they put in their pocket had the word wisdom. Every time that they got into a place where they didn't know what they were supposed to do, they were supposed to feel in their pocket, grab that little wooden nickel and say, Lord, you are the wisdom that I need. I need you now in my life and in my heart because I don't know what to do. So they gathered them with them. But know that we do have hardships being a Christian. There's just no way. We live in a world that is full of sin. But we still walk with the Lord, and we still ask for wisdom. No one serving in an army gets entangled in everyday affairs. The soldier's aim is to please the enlisting officer. So what is our aim? Our aim is to please the Lord God Almighty, to please Jesus Christ, and to rely upon the Holy Spirit. And that goes all the way through your life, not just this day, but all the way through your life. And if you were an athlete and you were running a race, would you practice? Yeah, you would practice. Would you follow the rules? If you didn't, what happens? Yeah, qualification, disqualification. So in the case of an athlete, no one is crowned. You don't receive your crown without competing first and according to all the rules. That is a valuable lesson to learn, is be prepared, be ready, because you are being called on every day. You are being watched every day, especially when you claim that you are a Christian. People want to see that. So we are running a race here, but the goal is the Lord God. Think over what I say, for the Lord will give you understanding in all of this. Remember Jesus Christ, what he do for us. He raised from the dead, correct? Yes. And Paul, he was one that proclaimed the message to the people that didn't want to hear it, to the Jews. And many of them did not like him. And he was actually writing this letter from prison. He was actually writing it in chains. Simply because he proclaimed the name of Jesus Christ simply because he was a follower of Jesus Christ. And today that's what our claim is here, that we are to be followers of the Lord Jesus Christ, even if it means sitting in jail. It's a hard choice to make, but it's the best choice that you can make in your whole life, the very best choice. Therefore, endure everything for the sake of the elect. You endure for other people to see and watch, and they follow after you. If your stance is on the Lord Jesus Christ, there's something in you that is not in the rest of the world. And they know that there's something different about you, and they are drawn to you. Some will not be drawn to you. Some will be like with Paul, that they hated him, didn't want him to say anything. But God is by far more valuable, and Jesus Christ is, than the human being is. So this morning, as we're thinking of confirmation, this is a dedication of your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. You're choosing a path of where you're going to take your life. So it says endure, because some things won't be easy, but some things will be necessary. And when hardships comes, that means that we endure, but it also strengthens us because we know that we do not stand alone. We stand with God. And the ones you influence are also God's chosen ones. Why? Why do we do that? Why do we do all of that? So that others may also know Jesus Christ as you know Jesus Christ, as Lord and Savior of your life. the one that laid his life down for you completely. The saying is sure and true. If we died with him, we shall also live with him. And again, if we endure, we will also reign with him, that he will bring us up alongside, and we will reign with him in his new kingdom of where he will be. And we also reign here in the earth. Although the world does not consider that we're reigning, we still are reigning. We are God's people here. And we need to remember that he will always be faithful, even if we're not. Even if our faith is so weak that we don't even realize that we have faith, his faith is always there. It will never let us down. But as it said before, if we deny him, if we deny the Lord Jesus Christ, he will also deny you. That is a hard saying, but it is a truth saying, and it's one that we need to know. And we need to remember, who do we follow? Who do we serve? Do we serve the world? Do we serve our friends? Do we serve money? Who do we serve, and what do we serve? James? We serve God. We serve the Lord Jesus Christ in all things. Always keep that hard in your heart, that that's who we serve. We serve Jesus Christ. Do your best. Do your best. Remind them of this and warn them before God that they are to stop arguing over words which do no good, but only ruins those who are listening. And do we not all do that? We all get into worthless debates and arguing and debating back and forth. They usually end up not doing anything, more destruction than they are good. So please. But our last one is Paul sends to Timothy. Do your best. That's what God asks for. He asks for your best. And sometimes we have to admit it, our best is none too good. But it's the best we have at the moment and at that time. So stand on that. And you can tell the Lord openly, I'm not doing very good today. And I really have a hard time doing my best today. But Lord, I'm trying. And the Lord will still look down and smile upon you and say, trying. But do your best. Do your best to present yourself to God as one approved by him, a worker who is not ashamed, who is not ashamed to explain the gospel to those that do not know, to explain to them your story of why you love the Lord Jesus Christ, your story as to why it has affected your life, why Jesus has affected your life, and how you have lived, because you are the only one that can tell your story and your walk with the Lord Jesus Christ. And don't ever again think nobody's watching. They're watching you. They're watching all of us that call ourselves Christian. Are we ambassadors for Jesus Christ? Yes, we are ambassadors. So let us be faithful ambassadors. Are we soldiers in his army? Yes. We listen for his voice. We do his commands. The Lord knows those who are his. The Lord knows that everyone who calls on the name of the Lord, and we need to know this, will not be turned away from him, but will be welcomed with wide open arms every day. We know that some days we don't make it very well. But God is a God of patience that waits for us till when we can finally kneel before him again and say, Lord God, forgive me. Forgive me. And his arms are there so quickly, and his blood washes over us. And we are saved in the blessed name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, for these young ones and for all here, let us be faithful to you. Let us be good stewards of all the things that you have given us as we worship and praise and proclaim your name over and over again. In the blessed name of Jesus Christ, amen. Please turn in your hymnals to Take This Life and Let It Be. Please be seated. At this time, we're going to have the confirmation class all stand up as I read. Okay, you want to come over here. We have been working on the books of the Bible. There's a paper down there that'll help. This is a song they were turning. You got to turn around and look at them. So I'm going to read off your names so everybody knows, okay? So just raise your hand and say, that's me. I tried to have him speak into the microphone, and that didn't go so well. So anyway, so, all right, we're going to start with the oldest. Okay, all right, you ready? Joshua Stegan, James Stegan, Jasmine Stegan, Luke Carlson, Jean Carlson, Eli Sharp, Haley Dittmerson, and Genevieve Jones. They kind of all sat in bunches like that. So, Jessica, you want to start our song?
Let's learn the books of the Bible. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, and Saul. Psalms and Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Songs. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible because we love God's Word. Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, and Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. You did it! That's the Old Testament. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible because we love God's Word. You guys are doing great, but let's speed it up for the New Testament! Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Acts, and Romans, 1st and 2nd Corinthians, Galatians, and Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1st and 2nd Thessalonians, 1st and 2nd Timothy, Titus, and Philemon. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible because we love God's Word. Let's keep going, everybody! Hebrews and James! Hebrews, James, 1st and 2nd Peter, 1st, 2nd, 3rd John, Jude and Revelation. Oh yeah, we did it! That's the New Testament. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible because we love God's Word. Now we know the books of the Bible. Now we know the books of the Bible. Now we know the books of the Bible because we love God's Word. Because we love God's Word.
They have a way to go yet. I mean, that's better than when they started. They didn't know anything, so. They all have them on their phones, but evidently that wasn't one of their favorite songs so far. So this has been our class. It's been interesting to have them, like I said. We've all learned to come together. They did have all of their books of the Bible are on cards. That's how they're supposed to learn. And so we're still working on that. So as most of you already know, we skipped a couple weeks in here because nobody was going to be here. So confirmation will pick up after we get done up here too today. So we'll reschedule some of those that we missed. So it has been my pleasure to have all of them. So this morning as we come with our requests for our confirmation class. Are we ready? Are y'all ready? Okay. Brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are brought together in Christ's holy church. We are incorporated in God's mighty acts of salvation and given a new birth through the water and the Spirit. All up here have been baptized. Your parents baptized when you were little. They dedicated you to the Lord. Confirmation now is you dedicating yourself to the Lord. It is no longer your parents' choice. It is yours that you will be followers of the Lord Jesus Christ. Through confirmation, you are reaffirming your faith. You are renewing that covenant declared at your baptism and acknowledge what God is doing for us and affirm the commitment to Christ's Holy Church. Today is a great honor to present you this day, these honorable young people that stand up here. As of yet, they do not know what they will be, but God already has a plan for their lives. He tells us that in Jeremiah, I have a plan for you before you are even born. Today, the profession of faith are questions that I am going to ask you. And on behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce spiritual forces of wickedness and reject evil powers of this world? And do you repent of your sin? If so, say, I do. Do you accept the freedom and the power that God gives you? He gives you power to resist evil, injustice, and oppression. In whatever forms they may present themselves, If so, say, I do. Please remember, you are answering for yourself before the throne of God, not just here. Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Do you put your whole trust in His grace? And do you promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church and with the body of Christ, which has opened to all people of all ages and nations and races? If so, answer, I do. According to the grace that Jesus Christ has given you, will you remain faithful members of Christ's holy church, the full body of Christ, and serve as representatives of Christ in your world and this world? If so, answer, I will. I would ask the congregation if they would please take the hymnals and turn to page 35, section 8. This is addressed to you. Eli, I'm standing for you. Do you, as Christ's body of the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ?
We do.
Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life and include these wonderful confirmands now before you into your care?
With God's help, we will
proclaim the good news. To live according to the example of Christ. We will surround them in the community of love and forgiveness, that they may grow in their trust of God and be faithful in service to others. We will pray for them that they may be true disciples who walk in the way that leads to life. Let us join together in professing the Christian faith, the Apostles' Creed. Do you believe in the Father God Almighty?
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator
of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit,
born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. Descended from the head. On the third day he arose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life.
Amen. Thank you. Welcome into the family of faith. Welcome to the family of faith. Welcome to the family of the Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to this family. Welcome to me. The family of God. Welcome to the family of God. Welcome to the family of God. And welcome to the family. If you would like to, please, we have lunch afterwards, but they're going to sit down again for a while, and we'll get them back, okay? We normally ask in this church if anybody has joys and concerns and things that they would like to pray about this morning. Is there anybody here? Okay. This morning I'm going to just say a short prayer. Okay. There is a time here for a silent prayer, so we'll be still for a little while. So, but we welcome them into this family and their blessings to be upon them. Lord, we pray for all these confirmants. Over and over again, we'll pray for them because they need our prayers. to continue to lift them before the throne of God, before you, O Lord. They will be a huge blessing, and they are a huge blessing to all of us that are here. So please, O Lord, guide them daily. Even if they don't ask, please guide them daily through life and protect and watch over them and keep them, Lord. There are so many things that want to take them in a different direction, Lord, but with your walk with them and your Holy Spirit in them, keep their feet on the path that you have already created for each and every one of them. And as the church has taken the responsibility upon them to pray for them and to love them and to keep them, we thank you, O Lord, for the precious gift that you have given to the body of Christ this day in the confirmands that are here. Thank you, Lord. We do thank you, Lord, also for the rain that we received this morning. We thank you for the little bit that is there, Lord, but through your abundance may more come, for you are the one that waters the earth and makes it fruitful and multiply, Lord, and man must wait on you for that. So we praise you, Lord, for the rain that came, and we ask, Lord, that you will continue your mercy and grace upon this land and upon us with showers of rain, but also showers of blessing. In the blessed name of Christ, we pray. Amen. At this time, we will receive our gifts and our offerings.
Let's learn the books of the Bible. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers and Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job and Psalms and Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Songs. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible because we love God's Word. Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel and Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. You did it! That's the Old Testament. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible because we love God's Word.
You guys are doing great, but let's speed it up for the New Testament!
Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Acts, and Romans, 1st and 2nd Corinthians, Galatians, and Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1st and 2nd Thessalonians.
From the works of our hands have been placed within this offering plate this day. We ask, O Lord, that you'll use it mightily, that you'll multiply it mightily, that it will also be used to bring in others that will love the Lord Jesus Christ with all their heart, with all their soul, and with all their mind. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Before we go, will you please join me in the Lord's Prayer? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, I would ask you to please turn in your hymnals to number 370 or on the board. So true, we have victory in Jesus Christ every day of our life. Go in the grace and the peace and the love of the Lord Jesus Christ. Be filled each day with his presence as you walk the roads of life here in this place. God's blessings be upon you as you listen for his voice. In his name we pray. We go and we serve. Lunch will be served afterwards, so please. In the blessed name of Jesus Christ, we ask all these things. Hallelujah and amen. Amen. God bless. And lunch will be, confirmands, you stay up here. Okay. Wipe your hands off because they're sweaty. Okay.